Okay, so if you ever wondered what are these blue areas when I look at my map, well, that's what I'm going to tell you about, because what these are what we call reputation contracts. And what that is if you'll go over to your goals, and you see this is where you get a lot of your ego from right here, but if you tab over one time, these are all of the reputation vendors right here. So that you see Sniper Ridge Assault. And then this has a Radio Restart, which is a bunch of different mini ones that you can earn for a weekly. And they all give you a daily and a weekly. And they pay you 50 for the weekly and 10 for the daily. And you'll get 7 dailies a week. Of course, it's a daily, and you only get one weekly. So it's a good way to earn these. Well, what are they? It's just simply when you drive into it and you finish it. So we'll come in here to this one. We're right nearby. And here's the problem. That is 10. Ugh. But anyways, you can come in here, kill off all the enemies, finish off this little area here. This little, I don't know what you want to call it, emergency area or whatever, but once you finish this area, it will give you the reputation points. And you can use those reputation points to hit a vendor. And here, I'll show you that right now. We'll go to one of the vendors and we'll show you. So you go to these. The little ones are normally the ones for the weekly, because you have to do multiple ones, if that's what it is. Sometimes you may have to do, say, a cooperative map. But we'll go to the crater here, because there's a reputation vendor there. And if you're not sure what a reputation vendor is, that's when you look in it and you see it costs more than scrip or keys or something like that to buy something. And there it spawns in, and you can see this is Selector, and it has the, even you can see it's the S and the E on the little symbol there. If you look at it right, that's how you know it's the Selector vendor, on top of the name popping up. And you see it costs script to buy the weapons in it, but it also costs reputation. So you can buy any of these weapons, which most people aren't that excited about, but what a lot of people like to do is this. This is the Selector Enterprises supply cache. Well, if you go to another one, say if you go to Top Notch, it'll be the Top Notch supply cache. And this can give you some pretty nice weapons, and it will give you legendary weapons too. So that's why a lot of people like to do these contracts. And I mean, you already want to do this, because if you're new to the game, this helps you with ego, because you want to become, let's see, we'll show you. We'll go ahead and we'll pop over into this again. Once again, back to goals. So here we go to, it's in here somewhere, reputation. So you see, you want to complete contracts to get ego points, so you'll level up. And it's all about doing those until some of it is becoming reliable status or higher, or familiar status with the vendors. So that's one of the reasons you want to do those dailies. You want to do them so that you can get all of the ego points out of this, so that you'll level up. Plus, what you can do by getting into the box. Now, I mean, I really don't want much in this if I was going to buy anything. But you can buy this one, but this isn't going to give you the mods for your normal guns. It'll give you the mods for the guns that would come out of here. So if you look at the synergies, let's see, does one of them have a synergy? Like Scavenger. It'll give you like Scavenger. You don't normally get Scavenger guns on a drop. You don't get Scavenger guns on a drop. So that's the type of mods you're going to pull. So most people would actually use their reputation to buy the epic mod hoard if they're like me and they don't really want to hit the supply crate. And I'll just save up 75 keys, spend 40,000 script, which is a lot to spend for mods, and 100 reputation points. And that's normally what I do with mine. Maybe I'll get lucky and get mods I want. So that's kind of what you can do with your points. And they're scattered all over the place, because there's one here at the crater. If you do that, there's not, this one isn't so good. So this one has, right there, you see it's got Echelon vendor in it, and that's not a very good vendor. A lot of people are not happy about that. You can go to Top Notch here, and it has the Top Notch Toolworks vendor. Then you can go up here to Shandu's. Shandu's has the Von Bock Industries. So see, they're all over the place. And Iron Demon. Iron Demon has the Paradise Territory vendor, which you really have to do that really doesn't do you a whole lot of good for the most part, unless you were doing the cooperative maps on Expert. And this one has the 7th Legion vendor in it. So you can go to these places and spend your hard-earned reputation there. I think there's something at Headlands. Yeah, the Chimera vendor is here at Headlands. And if you're in Diablo and you're doing the Thorn Lero arenas, then you can also use your reputation earned from those at the Thorn Lero vendor. But once again, there's no mod cachet in those two. There's no weapons boxes, which is what a lot of people do want to hit. So that is what all these little blue dots are. They earn you reputation. They get your weekly and daily contracts done, which you want to do so that you can get the ego evolution if you're not that far in. Or you can just do them so that you can hit the boxes. And those boxes, the weapon ones, will give you legendary items. So a lot of people like to take the chance for getting those. And technically, those don't cost you keys, and they don't cost you 40,000 scripts. So, I mean, if you're new to the game, that's what I would suggest doing, was going to one of those vendors. But that's what they are. But you'll see contracts do other things too, like what you saw me doing earlier. Well, nearby, I was over here. But this here, let's go back over into our contracts and look for 7th Legion. See, that's always the dailies to complete an incursion. And then this is the one that's different. 7th Legion will give you 2 weeklies, but they only pay you 25 instead of 50. So this is complete 5 incursions. And this one is complete 5 incursions. That normally doesn't happen that way. So apparently you complete 5 incursions, you'll get both of these. Normally one of them is complete 5 incursions and the other one is kill this or do all of these co-op maps. So that's normally how 7th Legion works. But you can see, as through looking at them, the weekly is always pretty much something kind of big to do. It takes you a minute longer to do it. But if you're wondering what all those blue dots are, that should hopefully more than explain it. And you'll at least understand what it is as to whether you choose to do them or not. When you do one, this blue dot will disappear. It will no longer be there anymore to let you know that you have done it. Let you know kind of where do I need to go to get stuff done. It kind of points it all out to you. And good, there's nothing down south. Oh, just one. Okay. Those get a little difficult down there. They're kind of glitchy. But hopefully that'll explain what some of the reputation stuff is, what you can do with your reputation, and where to get the reputation at. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll catch you guys later.